Hi everybody, today is February 1st, 2013. I just did an article about the conflict that's going on in Burma. Briefly touched on how Clinton was trying to do negotiations to put in our Navy bases along their coastline. Burma, which is now called Myanmar, was on the list of human rights violations. And she said that because that this dictatorship was no longer doing these violations, they were going to allow export trades, etc. And it was just a bribe to hopefully get our Navy ports put in there again that were closed after the Vietnam War. And it's all bullcrap. Makes me mad. These atrocities are still ongoing. I found a link in the other video to one of their websites that shows the fighting, the death, the civilians that are being killed. And it looks just like Vietnam. This article reads, Clinton counts improved Burma ties among top accomplishments. On the eve of her departure from her position as America's top diplomat, U.S. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton on Thursday counted the dramatic improvement in the U.S.-Burma ties among her major foreign policy achievements. This government is brutal in what it does to its people. Supporting the historic opening there, Burma took a blend of economic, diplomatic, and political tools. The country's leaders wanted the benefits of rejoining the global economy. See, they were banned because of all their atrocities. Clinton told the packed auditorium of the Council on Foreign Relations, a Washington-based think tank, in her last major foreign policy speak as Secretary of State. Clinton said the Burmese leadership, it's now called Myanmar, wanted to more fully participate in the region's multilateral institutions and to no longer be an international pariah. So we needed to engage with them on many fronts to make that happen. Pressing for the release of the political prisoners and additional reforms, while also boosting investment and upgrading our diplomatic relations, Clinton said in her remarks. Now, notice the boosting investments. That's all the big corporations. Japan just recently canceled their $3.58 billion debt that they owed Japan. I think that's because of the coming war over these disputed islands. They want to get as many allies on their side as they can. Here's an article on the 29th. They just abolished their 25-year-old ban on public gatherings of more than five people at a time. It was to crush nationwide pro-democracy protests. So now they're a member of the World Trade Organization. It has recently started healthy trade relations with neighboring countries including India, Thailand, and China. And they're even sending two observers to this war games they're having there in the Pacific for the Cobra Gold. Here's a list of a few of the global companies that want to move in there. Coca-Cola, Pepsi Company, General Electric, Intel, etc. It goes on to say that, but it was her Burma policy that won the highest praise from senators in the U.S. Congress. Through deft diplomacy, she has slowly opened Burma to the outside world. She has encouraged them to free political prisoners, hold parliamentary elections, and finally permit foreign investments. And the only reason she got involved in this is because they want to put our naval bases there again. It is happening before our eyes, said Senator Ben Nelson in a speech on the Senate floor. Are these guys that blind? All these corporations going in, all because of greed and the hell with human rights. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.